गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द 3 मार्क इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द चैप्टर कंटिन्यूटी एंड डिफरेंशिएशन। सो हियर ही हैज गिवन दैट सम ऑफ द पैरामेट्रिक फंक्शंस एंड वी नीड टू फाइंड आर प्रूव द वैल्यू ऑफ dy / dx। हियर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इफ x इज इक्वल्स टू sin t, y इज इक्वल्स टू cos 2t, then we need to prove that the value of dy / dx is equal to minus 4 sin t. Let's start the solution. So here x is equal to sin t and y is equal to cos 2 t. So x and y are the parametric functions of the parameter t. Therefore we know that dy / dx is equal to dy / dt divides dx / dt. So to find the dy / dx, we need to find dy / dt and dx / dt. So that x is given, x is equal to sin t. Since x is a function of t, so we need to differentiate x with respect to t. Differentiation of x with respect to t is dx / dt, and differentiation of sin t is cos t. And next, y is given. Y is equal to cos 2t. Y is also function of t, therefore we need to differentiate y with respect to t. So differentiate with respect to t. Differentiation of y with respect to t is dy / dt, which is equal to differentiation of cos 2t is minus sin 2t, and then differentiation of 2t is 2. Hence dy / dt is equal to minus 2 sin 2. So to find the value of dy / dx, substitute this value of dy / dt and dx / dt in equation number 1. So therefore equation 1 implies the value of dy / dx is equal to dy / dt is minus 2 sin 2t, minus 2 sin 2t divided by dx / dt is cos 2. So we need to prove that the value of dy / dx is equal to minus 4 sin t. Hence we know that the formula for sin 2t is what? 2 sin t into cos t divided by cos t as it is. So therefore here cos t get cancelled. The value of dy / dx is minus 2 into 2 minus 4 into sin. So this is our required proof. That is what dy / dx is equal to minus 4 sin. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a look. So now the second question. Here he has given that if x is equal to a into theta plus sin theta and y is equal to a into 1 minus cos theta, we need to prove that dy / dx is equal to tan theta / 2. Let's start the solution. So here x is given as a into theta plus sin theta. And y is a into 1 minus cos theta. Here also x and y are the parametric functions of the parameter theta. Therefore dy / dx is equal to dy / d theta divided by d dx by dt. So to find dy by dx, we need to find dy by d theta and dx by d theta. So let x is equals to a into theta plus sine theta. Since x is a function of theta, therefore differentiate with respect to theta. Differentiation of x with respect to theta is dx by d theta, which is equals to a is a multiple and it is a constant as it is. Differentiation of theta with respect to theta is 1 plus differentiation of sine theta is cos theta. I hope all of you understand. Now the value of dy by d theta, he has given that y here. The value of y is a into 1 minus cos theta. Again, y is a function of theta, therefore differentiate with respect to theta. Differentiation of y with respect to theta is dy by d theta. So a as it is, because it is a multiple and as it is a constant. Derivative of 1 with respect to theta is 0. Minus derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta. Minus into minus, plus sin theta. Therefore the value of dy by d theta is a into sin theta. I hope all of you understand. Now for dy by dx, substitute this dy by d theta and dx by d theta in this equation number 1. So therefore equation 1 implies dy by dx is equal to dy by d theta is a sin theta divided by dx by d theta is a into 1 plus cos theta. So which is equal to, we know that half angle formulas, sin theta can written as 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, and the formula for 1 plus cos theta is 2 cos square theta by 2. Therefore a as it is, sin theta can written as 2 into sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 divided by a into 1 plus cos theta is 2 into cos square theta by 2. Now a and a get cancelled, 2 and 2 get cancelled, 1 cos theta by 2, 1 cos theta by 2 get cancelled. Hence the remaining dy by dx is equal to, in numerator sin theta by 2 is remaining, in denominator cos theta by 2 is remaining. Therefore sin theta by 2 divided by cos theta by 2 is tan theta, and this is our required proof. That is what dy by dx is equal to tan theta by 2. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a look. So now the third question. Here he has said that if x is equal to a into theta minus sin theta and y is equal to a into 1 plus cos theta, we need to prove that dy by dx is equal to minus cot theta by 2. Let's start the solution. Here the value of x is a into theta minus sin theta, and the value of y is a into 1 plus cos theta. So here also x and y are parametric functions of the parameter theta. So therefore dy by dx is equal to dy by d theta divides dx by d theta. Call it as equation number 1. For finding dy by d theta and dx by d theta, he has given that x is equal to a into theta minus sin theta. right? Y is equals to A into 1 plus cos theta. Since x is a function of theta, therefore differentiate with respect to theta. Differentiation of x with respect to theta is dx by d theta, which is equals to A is in multiple and it is constant as it is. Differentiation of theta with respect to theta is 1 minus differentiation of sine theta is cos theta. And now y is also function of theta. Therefore, differentiate with respect to theta. Differentiation of y with respect to theta is dy by d theta. A as it is, derivative of 1 with respect to theta is 0. Plus derivative of cos theta is minus sine theta plus into minus minus sine theta. Hence, the value of dy by d theta is equals to A into minus sine theta. That is what? Minus A sine theta. I hope all of you understand. Now substitute the value of dy by d theta and dx by d theta in equation number 1. So equation 1 implies the value of dy by dx is equals to dy by d theta is minus A sine theta divided by dx by d theta is A into 1 minus cos theta. A and A get cancelled. So minus sine theta can be written as by using the half angle formula 2 into sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 divided by the formula for 1 minus cos theta is 2 sine square theta by 2. 2 sine square theta by 2. So 2 sine square theta by 2. 2 and 2 get cancelled. Sine theta by 2, 1 sine theta by 2 get cancelled. Therefore, the value of dy by dx is equal to minus, in numerator remaining thing is cos theta by 2. In denominator remaining thing is sin theta by 2. So therefore the value of dy by dx minus cos theta by 2 divided by sin theta by 2 is cot theta by 2. And this is our required proof. Dy by dx is equal to minus cot theta by 2. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a note. Now the fourth question, here he has given that if x is equal to A into cos theta plus theta sin theta and y is equal to A into sin theta minus theta cos theta, we need to find the dy by dx. Let's start the solution. Here x is given as A into cos theta plus theta sin theta. And y is equals to A into sin theta minus theta cos theta. Here x and y are the parametric functions of the parameter theta. So dy by dx is equals to dy by d theta divides dx by d theta. So call it as equation number 1. For finding dx by d theta, he has given the value of x. X is equal to A into cos theta plus theta sin theta. Since x is a function of theta, differentiate with respect to theta. Derivative of x with respect to theta is dx by d theta, which is equal to A into derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta. Plus, for differentiating theta into sin theta, we need to apply the product rule. So theta as it is, derivative of sin theta is cos theta plus sin theta as it is into derivative of theta with respect to theta is 1. I hope all of you understand. Sin theta into 1 is sin theta. So plus sin theta minus sin theta get cancelled. Therefore, dx by d theta is equal to a into theta cos theta. So a theta cos theta. For finding dy by d theta, here he has given that y. The value of y is a into sin theta minus theta cos theta. Since y is a function of theta, therefore differentiate with respect to theta. The derivative of y with respect to theta is dy by d theta. A as it is. Derivative of sin theta is cos theta minus. For differentiating theta into cos theta, we need to use the product rule. So theta as it is, derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta plus cos theta as it is, derivative of theta with respect to theta is 1. So therefore dy by d theta is equal to a into cos theta minus into minus plus theta sin theta. Minus into plus minus cos theta. Minus cos theta plus cos theta get cancelled. Therefore the value of dy by d theta is equal to a into theta sin theta. That is a theta sin theta. For dy by dx, substitute the values of dy by d theta and dx by d theta in equation number 1. So equation 1 implies value of dy by dx is equal to dy by d theta is a into theta sin theta divided. Dx by d theta is a into theta cos theta. So a theta get cancelled. Remaining sin theta divided by cos theta. And we know that sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. Hence the value of dy by dx is tan theta. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take out. So now the fifth question, if x is equal to a into cos t plus log of tan t by 2 and y is equal to a sin t, then find dy by dx. Let's start the solution. Here both x and y are the parametric functions of the parameter t. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to dy by dt divides dx by dt. So call it as equation number 1. To find dx by dt, he has given that x is equal to a into cos t plus log of tan t by t. Since x is a function of t, differentiate with respect to t. Differentiation of x with respect to t is dx by dt. So a as it is, derivative of cos t is minus sin t plus derivative of log tan t by 2 is 1 divided by tan t by 2. And then derivative of tan t by 2 is second square t by 2. And then derivative of t by 2 with respect to t is 1 by 2. So therefore dx by dt is equal to a into minus sin t plus second square t by 2 divided by tan t by 2 can be expressed as 1 divided by cos square t by 2. Second square t by 2 is equals to 1 by cos square t by 2 divided by tan t by 2 can be written as sin t by 2 divided by cos t by 2. Man only in the untar cos t by 2 divided by sin t by 2 into 1 by 2. I hope all of you understand. So cos t by 2, 1 cos t by 2 get cancelled. Therefore, dx by dt is equal to a into minus sin t plus here 1 divided by the remaining series 2 into sin t by 2 into cos t by 2 into sin t by 2 into cos t by 2. So which is equal to a into minus sin t plus 1 divided by 2 sin t by 2 into cos t by 2 is the half angle formula for sin. So which is equal to here sin t is LCM, here multiply by sin t, minus sin t into sin t minus sin square t plus 1 divided by sin t. All of you understand. Therefore, dx by dt is equal to a into 1 minus sin square t is cos square t divided by sin. I hope all of you understand. Now, to find the dy by dt, he has given that y is equal to a sin t. So y is equal to a sin t. Y is a function of t. Therefore, differentiate with respect to t. So derivative of y with respect to t is dy by dt. So a into derivative of sin t is cos. For dy by dx, substitute this dy by dt and dx by dt in equation number 1. So equation 1 implies dy by dx is equal to dy by dt is a cos t divided by dx by dt is a into cos square t divided by sin t. I hope all of you understand. So which is equal to a cos t into manual ulta ki sin t divided by a cos square t. A and a get cancelled. Cos t, 1 cos t get cancelled. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to sin t divided by remaining cos t. So which is equal to sin t divided by cos t is tan. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a look. Now the sixth question. If x is equal to square root of a power sin inverse t and y is equal to square root of a power cos inverse t, we need to prove that dy by dx is equal to minus y by x. Let's start the solution. Here he has given that x is equal to square root of a power sin inverse t and y is equal to square root of a power cos inverse t. Call it as equation number 1 and this one is equation number 2. To prove dy by dx is equal to minus y by x, multiply equation 1 and 2. which implies that x into y xy is equal to square root of a power sin inverse t into square root of a power cos inverse t. So therefore xy is equal to square root of a power sin inverse t into a power cos inverse. Hence the value of xy is equal to square root of a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. It means a power sin inverse t plus cos inverse t. And we know that sin inverse theta plus cos inverse theta is equal to pi by 2. Therefore, in place of sin inverse t plus cos inverse t, we may write pi by 2. Therefore, xy is equal to square root of a power pi by 2. Now, differentiate with respect to x. So to differentiate xy, we need to apply the product rule. X as it is, derivative of y with respect to x is dy by dx, plus y as it is, derivative of x with respect to x is 1, which is equal to square root of a power pi by 2 is a constant value. Therefore, derivative of square root of a power pi by 2 is 0. So therefore, x into dy by dx plus y into 1 is y. Shift this plus y towards the right hand side, it becomes minus 1. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to minus y by x. And this is our required proof. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a look. Now the seventh question, differentiate sin square x with respect to e power cos x. Let's start the solution. Let us consider u is equal to sin square x and v is equal to e power cos x. We need to differentiate u with respect to v, it means du by du. Then both u and v are the parametric functions of the parameter x. Therefore, du by dv should be equal to du by dx divides dv by dx. Call it as equation number 1. So here we assume that u is equal to sin square x. U is a function of x, therefore differentiate with respect to x. Derivative of u with respect to x is du by dx, which is equal to derivative of sin square x is 2 sin x into derivative of sin x is cos x. And now there is given that v is e power cos x. V is a function of x, therefore differentiate with respect to x. Derivative of u with respect to x is dv by dx, which is equal to derivative of e power x is e power x, means e power cos x is e power cos x, and derivative of cos x is minus sin x. Now substitute these values of dv by dx and du by dx in du by dv. So therefore, equation 1 implies the value of du by dv is equal to du by dx is 2 sin x into cos x. Divided by dv by dx is minus sin x into e power cos x. sin x get cancelled. Therefore, du by dv is equal to minus 2 into cos x divided by e power cos x. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a look. Now the eighth question is, if y is equal to tan inverse of square root of 1 plus x square minus 1 divided by x, then prove that dy by dx is equal to 1 divided by 2 into 1 plus x square. Let's start the solution. Here he has given that y is equal to tan inverse of square root of 1 plus x square minus 1 divided by x. To prove dy by dx is equal to 1 divided by 2 into 1 plus x square, put x is equal to tan theta, which implies that the value of theta should be equal to tan inverse x. Therefore, the value of y is equal to tan inverse of square root of 1 plus x square means 1 plus tan square theta minus 1 divided by x means tan theta. We know that secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1, which implies that secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. Shift this minus tan square theta towards the right hand side, it becomes secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. It means in place of 1 plus tan square theta, we may substitute secant square theta. Therefore, the value of y is equal to tan inverse of square root of 1 plus tan square theta is secant square theta minus 1 divided by tan theta. So therefore, y is equal to tan inverse of square root of secant square theta is secant theta minus 1 divided by tan. Hence, the value of y is equal to tan inverse of secant theta can be written as 1 divided by cos theta minus 1 as it is, whole divided by tan theta can be written as sin theta divided by cos theta. I hope all of you understand it. Therefore, y is equal to tan inverse of, in numerator we may take cos theta as LCM, it becomes 1 minus cos theta divided by cos theta. Sin theta divided by cos theta, malo ulta yen antaru, cos theta divided by sin theta. I hope all of you understand it. Now cos theta get cancelled. Therefore, y is equal to tan inverse of 1 minus cos theta divided by sin theta. And we know that 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2 divided by sin theta is 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta. I hope all of you understand it. 2 and 2 get cancelled. 1 sin theta by 2 sin theta by 2 get cancelled. Therefore, y is equal to tan inverse of malle open to the sin theta by 2. In denominator remaining thing is cos theta by 2. So sin theta by 2 divided by cos theta by 2 is tan theta by 2. And we know that tan inverse of tan x is equal to x. Therefore, tan inverse of tan theta by 2 is theta. I hope all of you understand it. Therefore, the value of y is equal to theta is what? Tan inverse x. Therefore, tan inverse x divided by 2. I hope all of you understand it. So finally, we get the value of y is equals to 1 by 2 into tan inverse x. Now, for finding dy by dx, differentiate this y with respect to x. So derivative of y with respect to x is dy by dx, which is equal to 1 by 2 into derivative of tan inverse x is 1 divided by 1 plus x square. Therefore, the final answer for dy by dx is 1 divided by 2 into 1 plus x square. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a note.